why not? Okay, so yeah, there's something up here you have not been. It's probably just empty room. Yeah. Damn it. What's in the upper right? Nothing. Seriously? Huh? Okay, that's right. That's where, Kuketsu, I believe, was, but we managed to jank our way up there using a Valkyrie as a platform. You little bastards. Get out of here! No good. Please tell me I can just bat through this. Oh my god, you little imp shit. Bat through! Yeah! Esports. I still don't understand how you kill a tombstone with a gun. I don't think it works like that, but do I know? Okay. Let me see. Other areas. Again, like, the only areas that I have open to my map that I haven't been. So I know one's a mirror. One's a double-up mirror, which I don't think we can do anything with yet. There's a couple areas in the very beginning, and then there's the two doorways that I think are blocked by Frankenstein's monsters with pressure plates. Oh, had a look at tabletop tits, huh? What'd you think? She's actually been talking about getting back into Let's Playing again. I've got her convinced that there's a worthwhile and and fulfilling hobby. And she did some recording. She recorded some Slade Spire, I think is the name of the game. Which she plays the shit out of, so that should be interesting. They can block my bullets. Ahaha, but their feet are not immune. This looks for you, buddy. I just want to get to the teleporter. Leave me alone. Nope. 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 Okay. Okay. Where are we going? Oh, the waterfall. Okay. There's some stuff over there. Oh, we haven't been up. I have to take really quickly here my melatonin so that I can get a sleep later. Because otherwise I won't. Yeah, you are not wrong, Marble, and I warned her against it, but being my wife, she knows best. But yes, I completely agree with your assessment. Like, I told her to start with something short, and it was a game that she liked. But no, she started a fucking JRPG that she had no idea what she was getting into, and she had no idea how to do that. And I don't think that necessarily made her quit. She just didn't keep at it. I'm not going to pretend to understand what goes through that woman's mind. Oh, you dick merman! Oh. Yep. Yeah, I watched her play it, and like, it's a case of like for me like. Rogue Legacy, Enter the Gungeon, and those were like, I'd be good for like a session, and then I, you know, put it down for a couple hours or whatever. But she really likes that game, so it should be good, assuming she actually eventually starts uploading it, which, to be fair, she's out of the country right now, so she can't. But eventually. new area. Is this like... God, what would this be? I don't know what this is going to be. This is going to be a connector in part. Dungeon of the Endless. I feel like I recognize the name. Is that the one that's like partially a tower defense game that's set in the same universe as like Endless Legend and Endless Space? Yes, it is. I have heard of it. I have never played it. Oh no, this looks slightly different. This looks fantasy or like sci-fi instead of fantasy. Only two difficulties, easy and very easy. Maybe this is the one I was thinking of. I don't know. But no, it's another case of I've heard really good things about it, but I've never played it. Huh. I don't know. Like that's just the style of game that it just doesn't grab me for long durations of time. And it's like I don't get how people can like base their channels around that kind of game. Like I would go insane. But, you know, each their own. Sci-fi, a lot of fun. I don't know, maybe I'll check it out. Maybe. What I should do is, like, I don't know, like, maybe just set aside a night. Aquarius. Set aside a night where I just, like, go through and play, like, all of these games, but I play each game for, like, half an hour. Yeah, I'm not a fan of tower defense either. I haven't played tower defense games seriously since... Well, I was gonna say Warcraft 3, but that's wrong. God, there was one on Steam. I can't remember the name of it. That was actually really good. It was like a tower defense game, but instead of putting down towers, you put down NPCs that you would like level and stuff. And it was just really fucking fun to play. That's gonna bother me. What have I done? I accidentally clicked outside the window because I'm hitting the wrong buttons on my damn PS4 controller. Let's see, give me Puppet Master. Can I throw through here? Oh! This anything? No. Huh. I'm curious what the point of that is, unless it's to help you discover this. Whatever. We can now fly over this spiked pit bullshit here, so I guess this is where we're supposed to be going. Opening back passages aside. Man, I gotta look up that Steam game, it's gonna bother me. Can I search by tags? No. Oh, Jesus. It starts with a D, I believe. Defender's Quest. It's a tower defense game, but it's pretty good. I liked it a lot. And I would recommend it to anybody that's even passingly curious to the genre. Because it's got like I said, it's like an RPG. Your towers are RPG characters. Oh, this is some trash. Oh, I bet I'm supposed to throw a puppet over here. Puppet Master, and where is the one that lets me throw things for skill ring? Well, that was not what I wanted. Oh, am I supposed to just... No, I can't just... Oh, am I? You're seriously supposed to just... No, I can't... Can I turn into a bat underwater? No... Fewer floors would have made a better shorter runs for more games faster progression. Yeah! Like, that's what I liked about Defender's Quest, is that, like, any given level... You're in it for like 3 or 4 minutes, and that's it. So like you constantly feel like you're progressing, and it's got like an RPG storyline. So it's not just like, you know, here's a bunch of monsters. No, there's like a plot line you follow along. I'm gonna look really quick at Aquarius. Water resistant robe imbued with elemental power. Nowhere near as good as Eversing, sadly. How in the hell? Walls. I seem to recall getting stuck on this in the past. So once more. Google! Because there's also a area in one of the towers that we'll be able to get past in advance. Two ways to do this. Drop down on the broken spikes, use Bone Arc. The Bone Arc Soul, which we don't have. Let's see. Drop down on the broken spikes, equip Skillering or Skeleton Ape, and throw a Puppet Master. Alright, so that's what I thought I was doing. Yeah, that is what I was doing. But we can't. Unless I can, like, charge it? No. Alright, so we need a Skeleton Ape. Pit. Swords of the Star of the Pit? Yeah, I like Swords of the Star of the Pit. From what I understand, a lot of people did not like that game. I don't know why. I didn't think it was bad. It wasn't, like, as deep as a lot of roguelikes. But I didn't think it was bad at all. Like, if there's, like, roguelikes, I mean, if you guys want to watch me play roguelikes, I'll play Dungeon Mans. Like, I will play that game for hours. I really like Dungeon Mans. But aside from that, like, I mean, I've got, like, Tales of Majeol, but I'm actually not too big a fan of that. I think it's got too much, like, bullshit number bloat in it. And, like, a lot of the abilities are like, oh, your attacks deal 1% more damage. That doesn't really... the puppet, when you throw it, you teleport to it. Assuming it doesn't land in something that'll murder your ass. Which, with just the Skellerang, it does. So I think I need to go farm up a Bone Ape. Soul. Go from there. Yeah. I agree. I think Swords of the Star of the Pit is pretty solid. Definitely. It pleases me to hear that there is a sequel in the works. All they really, man, like, if they had, like, some modding support in that game, holy shit, I would be going at it. I would be throwing together just absolute horrors. Great. But then, I'm just kind of big on anything that has modding, I guess. Okay, easy place to farm Bone Apes. I guess right here we can go up and there's like a couple. This is rough. Expecting me to have complicated combinations of frickin' dead things. I don't know. Let me talk to. I wanna. When she gets back. Like, I have really liked having the freedom, like, stream during the week this week. Oh, you shit lord! This is gonna be a challenge. Can I just, like, come and shoot in the face? No. Let's see which is the quickest way to kill him. They're both about the same. Alright. Anyways, I'm gonna have a talk with my wife. Okay, I'm gonna start streaming, like, during the week. I would like to get more than just my Sunday stream in, and now with, like, Let's Plays finishing up, particularly Path of Exile and Betrayal at Krondor next week, I'm gonna have more time during the week to stream. So I might try streaming, like, I mean, I can stream on Thursdays, like, during the day, because she has choir every Thursday, although I want to say that's ending soon. What her schedule is, but yeah, I want to get at least one more stream in a week, I think. Let's see, guy you mentioned can't stream, streamed a lot of it. He gave me goes to a stream, he played Dungeon Mans 2. I think he left out on an early run, so he went on something else. Dungeon Mans, I assume that lucking out is bringing Dungeon Mans. Dungeon Mans is a game that you very quickly snowball in power, and once you've got one character that can beat the game, you can basically almost guarantee every other character can beat the game. Because typically your first character you beat the game with will have access to cosmic forged weapons, and they're just so out and out better than everything else. Like, it will pretty much trivialize the rest of the game. Which is one of the game's failings. Having been said, though, I still just enjoy playing the game. game. I like everything about it. I like the humor, I like the music, I like the graphics, I like the art style, and the dev is a really cool guy. It's something that I probably should stream sometimes. Alright, there's our skeleton ape. That was actually really painless, and I'm thankful for it. Let's get out of here and find somewhere to save before I end up killing myself. But if this guy's playing a lot of Swords and Stars Pit, let me really quickly teleport here. Come into my users. Are you a regular? Oh god. Alphabetize this shit. This is not alphabetized at all. Yes, you are in fact irregular. Alright, let me check something. Because I have it so that people that just randomly pop in can't post links in chat, but I think regulars can, but I don't want my bot to get a little uppity and ban you if you do. So, let's see. Mod tools. Let's see. Link protection. Exempt regulars. Alright. Link this dude in chat, please. So that I can check out his channel. Because I'm all for watching robot gameplay. I don't necessarily play him super hard, but I dig it. I think the thing that really got me for Dungeon Mans is like the soundtrack, and I think it was purposefully done because it's like one of the developers' favorite games. The soundtrack takes a lot of cues from Final Fantasy Tactics, and I adore that game's soundtrack. So like anything that sounds even remotely like it, I'm gonna, you know, just be screeching. This doesn't work. I'm going to be incredibly salty if I've got to go find whatever this bone arc thing is. I don't even know what a bone arc is. Sounds like something that Indiana Jones would be hunting down. Incredible power. Sure. There we go. Nice. Okay, now I don't remember what I had on here. No, this is my death ray, wasn't it? No. What was this? Was this my death ray? Don't actually. When it comes to my unset, no, this wasn't my death ray. My death ray is. Which set am I on? Alright, I'm on my sword set. I'm just being stupid. Okay. My sword set is Curry. Where's my skeleton waiter? There he is. And the strength boost. There we go. Oh, that's fucking terrifying. Umbilical cords on the walls. That is like, that is creepy as shit. Will you snap it off if you come too far? Oh my god, that's hilarious. Also, he's like, is he gonna die? Oh my god, and then they suffocate. Holy shit, that is like some dark stuff right there. I love it. Oh, did the bot? Bot, the asterisks in your chat there, did the bot pull you? I can't tell. Which, it would be weird if it did. I'm salty about it. If it did, just whisper it to me. And I'll beat the shit out of the bot once the stream ends. Alright. Thank you. And supposed to exempt you, but no! Ghostbot has a mind of his own. He's not a good bot. So what are these? Homunculus. Summons a homunculus. Oh god, I don't even want to know. A bloody stud. Ew. Nope, nope. This is death ray! Yeah, everybody dies! Silly man. Homunculus. I assume they're common? Yeah, super common. Probably, if I had to guess, because they're homunculi soul and they tend to suck. Minion souls, I should say. Oh, 666. Seriously, game? You're gonna lock something back here? Trash. Lucky Luck 2. Thank you for the links, Marwin. Give him a launch. Oh my god, get away from me! Damn merman! You shoot fireballs, I shoot death rays. Can we all just get along? Also bullets. Alright. Come on. Oh, there's... Oh, okay. Weird. Oh, it's like dark. Weird. Oh, this is a pain in the dick! We have walls that are only revealed when these assholes are, like, skittering over them. And I'm expected to navigate this somehow. Alright. So is this, like, seriously the only way? Like, right over here? Yeah. Oh, wow. Alright, this is gonna be painful. I'm gonna need Okay. Alright, we're in. Esports. First try. Fuck you, game. Yeah. Oh. Oh, man. Oh, an iron golem. One damage? Oh, you bet your ass it's one damage. Oh, you guys are a pain in the ass. I'm sure you got like a trajillion hit points. I don't even know if you can kill these things. We gotta get past it. Sadly. I just like... Bend forward and breathe your fiery breath so that I can kick jump over your face. Thank you! Spit stuff's way down the list. Link is the vids in list form. Can't stand the weird one. Sure thing. I will give it a gander. Maybe something to listen to while I'm programming and stuff. Okay. So obvious, this is gonna be backtracking, so I'm gonna actually wanna stick my nose through here. Yeah, that's what happens. You take your eyes off me. Weird. Who the fuck are you? Aside from fucking creepy heart eaters. Oh, they eat my mana, is that? Or do you guys just drop a shitload of mana? I don't know, but it's disturbing all the same. Yeah, that was an iron golem. There's one of those in Aria of Sorrow. This thing is apparently just... What even is this? Immune to bullets. Only hits me if I'm close to him. That is just fucking weird. He actually almost killed me. I wasn't even paying attention. I was too mystified by his forked up hitboxes. Yeah, there's an iron golem in Aria, I want to say. I think there's also one in Symphony of the Night? Maybe? Yeah, their whole shtick is that, like, you only ever hit them for one damage. I don't know if they ever actually drop anything worth anything. Neck warmer. Attack and constitution. You bet your butts. Both sides. Alright. What is this? Alright. I just nuked my way an extra entrance of town. Sure, I blew up the fountain. Oops. What you get for trusting a teenager with explosives? I'll check over here real quick. Like, use some hairspray. Eh. Okay, well, we did that, and I have no freaking clue what it would have done for us going through that whole underground area, because we really didn't get anything. Music is, in fact, back to nostalgia, at least for the time being. I'm gonna hit shops, and then we gotta call it here, because actually 6 a.m. crept up on me a little quicker than I was expecting. Hammer, what's... is this an actual thing that I could, like, throw a puppet through? Alright, what's up, Hammer? Oh, God. You kind of understand, you think it's a little too freaking... Oh, my God. Julius, shut the fuck up, Hammer, and sell me guns! Jesus Christ, man. You have anything I care about? No new weapons. Wish I could dual-wield guns. Yeah, you have nothing. Hammer, you are useless to me! Yeah, nice and early, like a proper vampire. I'll be up for a little while. Typically once I'm done recording. Yeah, recording. I love it! I love it! It's just like, it's Let's Plays all the way down, guys. Typically once I'm done streaming, I take a little while to split the video and stuff and get it ready for eventual YouTube uploading. Serenity. Eh. I guess we'll hold on to the rare ring for inevitable farming opportunities. Yeah. I don't know, that's like, that's the perk to night shift, is I get to stay up when it's all quiet. Pretty wonderful. Downside is that, you know, we actually don't need to talk to her about any weapon synthesis because the game refuses to give me Valkyrie souls. Save and call it. So, as per usual, folks, thanks for watching. Hope y'all had a good time. And we'll be picking this back up, you know, Sunday. And I'm gonna try and squeak in another stream, probably during the daylight hours at some point this week. Till then, take it easy, and I will catch folks around.